Now, next problem is a very good problem as it involves a lot of tricks and concepts. We are given that if a 1 upon a plus omega plus 1 upon b plus omega plus this expression is equal to 2 omega square and this expression is equal to 2 omega, then we need to prove that 1 upon a plus 1 up till 1 upon d plus 1 is equal to 2. Now, first of all, we will try to concentrate on these two equations. Since the left hand side of this expression is comprising of just omega, so we convert this omega square into omega and rewrite the given expression as 1 upon a plus omega up till 1 upon d plus omega is equal to 2 upon omega, since omega cube is equal to 1, so omega square is equal to 1 upon omega. Similarly, for the second expression, we rewrite this expression as 1 upon a plus omega square plus 1 upon b plus omega square up to 1 upon d plus omega square equals 2 upon omega square. Now, what we can see is these two expressions are similar type of expressions, and this is a third similar type of expressions which we need to prove. So, instead of these two equations, we can rewrite a general expression in x as 1 upon a plus x plus 1 upon b plus x plus 1 upon c plus x plus 1 upon d plus x equals 2 upon x. And seeing from these two equations, the two roots are omega and omega square, since omega and omega square are satisfying this expression. And from this result, which we need to prove, we can very clearly see that we need to prove that x equals 1 also satisfies. So, we will try to prove that x equals 1 also satisfies this given expression. Now, we rewrite the entire expression in the form of a biquadratic as 2 into x power 4 plus x cube into sigma a, which is equal to a plus b plus c plus d, plus there is no coefficient of x square, so we write it as 0 into x square minus x times sigma abc, which is equal to abc plus bcd plus cda plus dab minus 2 abcd equals 0. This is a constant term, and we know that omega and omega square are the two roots of this biquadratic. So, let us consider the other two roots are alpha and beta, and we know that the sum of roots taken two at a time is 0. So, let us find the sum of roots taken two at a time. This is omega into omega square plus omega into alpha plus omega into beta plus omega square into alpha plus omega square into beta plus alpha beta, and the value is given to be equal to 0, since the coefficient of x square is 0. This is equal to 1. This we can write it as omega into alpha plus beta. This we can write again as omega square into alpha plus beta, and this as alpha beta equals 0. This becomes 1 plus omega square times alpha plus beta, clubbing these two terms together, plus alpha beta equals 0. And we know that omega square plus omega plus 1 equals 0, since omega is a root of the quadratic equation x square plus x plus 1 equals 0. Hence, on putting the value equals minus 1 over here, we get 1 minus alpha minus beta plus alpha beta equals 0. This becomes 1 minus alpha minus beta times 1 minus alpha equals 0, which gives 1 minus alpha into 1 minus beta equals 0. Hence, either alpha is equal to 1 or beta is equal to 1. Alpha and beta are the two roots which we assumed apart from omega and omega square, and we are getting either alpha is equal to 1 or beta is equal to 1. So, in either case, one of the root will be equal to 1, and hence we have proved that x equals 1 satisfies this equation, and hence on putting x equals 1, we get 1 upon a plus 1 plus 1 upon b plus 1 up till 1 upon d plus 1 is equal to 2, which was the desired result to be proved. Now you can see that this was a tough looking question, but we applied just the concepts of cube roots of unity, omega and omega square, and some of the tricks to solve the question in a very simpler way, and hence the desired result has been proved.